time in an ancient land of lights, magic, and cherry blossoms, he met a young demon named Aladdin. Aladdin began to create great works of architecture, but because he came from a humble family, his mother insisted that he be tactful and more efficient. One day, Aladdin was on his way to the river. The queen insisted on keeping the river for one princess, and all the treasures there. Namely, the princess Jane. Seeing Princess Jane, Aladdin fell for her at once. Just then, a magician named Jane, who wanted his son Don to marry Princess Jane. Jane's power alone might not impress the emperor, but he knew where to find a far greater magic.
We don't need anyone. I can handle this job. How? The treasure means far more things instead of that. We need some Lucy's thumbs up from our dirty work. You do. Young sir, may I see your drawing? Such a work of art. May you not sign it for me? Aladdin Wong? This is amazing. I am your long lost uncle, Jane. I've been traveling in Africa for many years. This is my son, Don. We are here on a suitable treasure. Why don't you join us? We're waiting for you. This is the place. Whoa! In the third there is a prize. In the ball, hungry eyes. Would you go just about? The gate will be uncovered now. You must walk through three rooms of treasure, but touch none. At the end of the cave, you will find a simple oil lamp. Bring me that first, then Aladdin. The rest is yours.
Very well, uncle.
What's so dangerous about this? Don't do my flesh and blood, but don't bring the fine shade of the shell of an itchy hut. It's treacherous in there. Let Aladdin better one to risk his neck.
Aladdin was sorely tempted by the treasure, but recalling the magician's words, he forged ahead.
All these treasures are way out of here. Or at least some light to see by.